Every Final Cut Pro user needs to add titles, video effects, transitions, and generators to the timeline. And you'll have your favorites that you use frequently. So why have you got to search for them every time you want them? Those of you that were familiar with Final Cut Pro 7 will remember the pre-install favorites bin, which was a folder that contained all of your user favorite effects. Unfortunately, that bin or folder is not supplied in the current version of Final Cut Pro. But it is easy to add your own folders to each of the different effect categories and have the convenience of your own favorite effects quickly at hand. Like these, titles, generators, video effects, and transition folders. In this quick video, I'll show you how to easily create your own favorites folders. My name's Bruce, and if we've met before, welcome back. Otherwise, please like and subscribe and press the bell so I can make more videos for you. First, I'll show you how to add a favorites folder for your titles, and it's the same process for transitions, generators, and video effects, and these are all collectively known as plugins. And a warning, if you collaborate on projects with other users, check the warning at the end of this video. The timestamp to that location is in the description below. And to start with, I'll add two third-party titles that you've got a license for to the Favorite Titles folder. Then I'll show you how to add any Apple-supplied titles to that folder. Of course, you need to own these third-party titles for them to work on your computer. These are the ones I'm going to add. M-Titles Cinematic, and you'll need to own the license. And Blank Adjustment Layers, which is a free download. And the link to that free download is in the description below. The process is to add a folder in the Finder. Click the Happy Mac icon in your dock. Select the Go menu at the top of your screen. Select the Home folder. Select the List view from the tabs, and you'll see a Movies folder. Click the right pointing arrow to expose the contents. And then the same for Motion Templates folder. And if you don't have a Motion Templates folder, you'll need to create one. I'll show you at the end of the video how to do this. And to quickly jump there if you need to, click the timestamps in the description below. All the folders you're able to work with are in the Motion Templates folder. Effects, Generators, Titles, and Transitions. Double-click the Titles folder, and the contents will show in a new window. Select the File menu at the top of the screen and select New Folder. An Untitled folder will be added to that window. Change the name to Favorite Titles. Now I'll quickly add a Favorites folder to the other effects. To continue with the Titles folder, first I'll add M Title Cinematic to the Favorite Titles folder. It's part of the M Title Cinematic 2 package, and you'll see the folder M Title Cinematic 2.09. Don't worry about what's inside, it's the whole folder that's needed. Hold the Option key, which will create a copy of the title as you drag it into the Favorite Titles folder. Expose the arrow on the Favorite Titles folder, M Title Cinematic is now inside. And to be clear, this is a duplicate, so you still have the original in the M Title Cinematic 2 folder, as well as a copy in the Favorite Titles folder. Next, I'll add the adjustment layers, which can be downloaded free from my website. Click the link above. And when you're on my page, click the link on the web page, and the adjustment layers will be downloaded to your downloads folder as a zip file. Open that folder and double-click the zip file, which will open adjustment layers folder. Drag that folder inside the favorite titles folder. Now let's go to Final Cut Pro to view that Favorite Titles folder. Drag the title to the timeline to use it. You can use the same process for any third-party generators, video effects, or transitions that you own. I'll quickly add some video effects to the favorite effects folder I created earlier. I'll use the Brett PowerTools free to download. These can be downloaded for free, and the link is in the description below. So far, you've seen how to add third-party plugins to the favorites folders. Unfortunately, you don't have access to the original Apple-supplied titles, generators, effects, or transitions, but there is a way to add them to your favorites folder. I frequently use the supplied dramatic title from the Build-In-Out category. To place a copy in the favorite titles folder, right-click on dramatic and open in Motion. It'll open in Motion 5, and you don't need to make any changes for this. All you need to do is press Save As, name it, and add it to the Favorite Titles category. A copy will be in your Favorite Titles folder when you open Final Cut Pro. And the same can be done for other types of effects. Finally, I need to advise you to beware when you use these Favorites folders. Thanks to BrettFX for pointing this out in the comments of one of our previous tutorials. If you collaborate on projects with other people, favorites folders should be used with much care. If you're unsure, best not to use them at all. It's because of the way that titles and other effects that's plugins work in Final Cut Pro. The exact same plugins need to be in the exact same locations. So if a plugin is used from a favorites folder and you shared your project with someone else, that plugin would need to be installed in the favorites folder by exactly the same name. It needs to be stored in exactly the same file path also. And you could do this by ensuring that the Active Motion Templates folder is exactly the same on both computers. If you don't share projects with other users, then this won't be an issue. And as I promised, there's a way to create a Motion Templates folder if you don't already have one. You need to have your Movies folder open, as I showed you earlier in the video, and if you're not there now, click the timestamp below. Make sure that the Movies folder is open in its own window, and from the File menu, select New Folder. An untitled folder will be added to the window. Name it exactly Motion Templates. Double-click that folder to open it in its own window. From the File menu, create new folders and name them exactly as Effects, Generators, Titles, and Transitions, and make sure the first letter is uppercase. And it won't work unless you use those exact names. And they'll look like this. You can now continue to add the favorite folders to each of these. Having favorites folders will save you a heap of time looking for effects that you frequently use. I hope you found this information useful. Please like and subscribe and press the bell so I can make more videos for you.